Hi everyone, and welcome to Chemistry with Kat. In today's video, we are going to learn all about isotopes. An isotope is a version of an element that has a different mass. Now you might think this is so bizarre, and it kind of is. The first scientists that discovered it were definitely in awe. We know that the mass of an atom comes from the nucleus. The nucleus contains the protons and the neutrons. Now, the protons cannot change. Remember that every element has a specific number of protons, and if that number changed, it would be a different element. For example, if an element has one proton, that means it is hydrogen. No ifs, ands, or buts. However, what can change is the number of neutrons. An isotope is a version of an element that has a different number of neutrons, which in turn makes it have a different mass. The example I'm going to use is boron. Boron has only two isotopes. B10 has 5 protons and 5 neutrons. The second is B11. B11 still has 5 protons. Remember, the protons cannot change. If the protons change, then we're not dealing with boron anymore. But it has 6 neutrons, which makes B11 heavier than B10. Now, we can't assume that these two isotopes occur in the same amount in the world. On the periodic table, the average atomic mass of both of these isotopes is 10.81 U. U is just a short form of saying atomic mass unit, which is how we measure atomic mass. Because this number is closer to 11, we know that the B11 is more abundant in the world. Now, many different isotopes can exist for the same element. For example, boron only has 2, but silicon has 3, which we'll see in tomorrow's video. In my next video, I'm going to teach you how to take the amount of isotopes in the world, aka isotopic abundance, and find the average atomic mass. What you see on the periodic table is exactly or pretty close to the average atomic mass. However, it's a very popular test question and super easy part marks on tests if you can show your work and show that you know how to calculate the average atomic mass. As always, if you liked this video and you learned something, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel.